Yeah, Dr. Shaw, thanks for speaking with us. Just in terms of general artificial reefs, have you been involved with ships going down as set as artificial reefs offshore? And can you give us some idea in general what generally happens to the surf breaks or the beach in general? Is there any adverse effects?
Yeah, I have been involved with them. As you may be aware, there's quite a few around New Zealand, and in one in particular on the south coast, there was that concern. Now there is a potential to block or defocus wave energy by wrapping it away and pulling in a wave due to the process of refraction, and knocking wave energy out. What we found, and what I found in South Coast, there were some concerns. There was two surf breaks, but where the boat was being located, it wasn't going to have any impact whatsoever. So in some cases, we've seen that you could actually be enhancing surf on a flat coast by actually breaking up that wave energy that comes in, so that you get some complexity in there in the circulation patterns. You get some rip cells making, and you actually make surf. So I think each case is different, but it's not a hard thing to look at. It's actually quite basic modelling to look at that. You've got your size of your boat, where it's going to go, and if you've got your wave climate and your bathymetry, away you go, and you can do some simple wave modelling.
In general, a ship of say 138 metres long, 1.8 metres off the coast, is that something that would be likely to have an effect?
Not likely at that distance. Really, with offshore submerged structures, the optimum effects of them, although there's a lot of other factors, but a good rule of thumb is that the longshore length of that structure, if it's between 2 and 4 times that distance offshore, is when it'll have the biggest effect on the coast. So say the structure's 100 metres wide. If you put it 200 to 400 metres offshore, you're going to have a bigger impact. And there's a lot of traditional literature on that. Once you get beyond that distance offshore, your ratio of distance offshore to the longshore width of that structure becomes so small that it's termed non-depositional. It won't actually have an impact on there. There is the potential, but I think it's a very low potential when you're that far offshore with a structure.
And in particular, the ships themselves, this particular reef we're looking at is in about 35 metres of water, and the structure will probably come up to about 12 metres, very high to the structure. So how does wave refraction sort of work around those sorts of structures?
Refraction really starts to happen when the water depth is about a quarter to a half the wavelength. So in that depth of water, it's going to have it has the potential to bend and move waves, even short period waves. For example, about a 14, 16 second period wave is feeling the bottom at about 200 metres deep. So, it's based on wavelength. So it can refract and change wave patterns, but what that impact will be, whether by the time it's gone past over 1.8 metres, 1.8 kilometres, it could have reorganised itself, so you won't be seeing a very big impact.
So basically, it could literally just sort of go around the structure.
Will bring it up and focus it together. So it could actually, depending where it is, if the boat was laying face into the... What it does then, what it would do, just a small potential, because it's only a small size, but what the wave energy that passes over it slows down, so the stuff on either side catches up, and you end up with the wave height increasing as it moves over that structure. It's robbing a little bit of the wave height on either side and increasing the wave height in the middle. Now, as that moves inshore, what happens, that could continue moving through itself, and you'd see hardly any impact, just a local diffraction and refraction pattern, and by the time you're that far in, nothing could happen, or it could have an impact. It could focus and cure a slightly higher area of wave height on the beach.
What about sand erosion? I know the structures that you're telling us actually tend to pull more sand onto the beach. Something like a ship 1.8 metres off the beach. Is that something would likely to scour sand or perhaps place sand back? Obviously, each situation is different, and you can only generalise.
Exactly. Well, in general terms, at that distance, as I said, I think it'd be non-depositional. If you moved it closer, you would likely build the beach out. You're knocking wave energy out. You're modifying wave energy, so you actually end up building the beach out. And there's lots of natural examples of that kind of stuff.
Okay. Thank you.